Hi there, welcome to another video from Hegarty Maths. It's Mr. Hegarty here, and in this video we're solving double linear inequalities. So, what I need you really good at is being able to just solve a normal single linear inequality. So pause the video and double check you could solve something like follows. Well, hopefully you would have said to yourself, right, solving this, you might have added 2 to both sides. And you would have said that 3x is therefore bigger than 3, and you would have divided both sides by 3, and you would have said x here bigger than 1. And you may have written it the other way around like that. You may have originally written the x's on this side and worked it out, x bigger than 1. But what if I told you these are the styles of questions we're going to do? What if I now told you that on top of that, 3x subtract 2 is also less than or equal to 7. Well, what you could do is you could go off down the other side and you could solve that one independently. 3x subtract 2 is less than or equal to 7. So you would add 2 to both sides. And you would get yourself, therefore, that 3x is less than or equal to 9. Then you would divide both sides by 3. And you would get yourself, therefore, that x is less than or equal to 3. Now, if I look at this way around of looking at it, if I just had the x on that side and I have the x there, I can combine those inequalities by putting the x in the middle and saying that the x is less than or equal to 3 but bigger than 1. I.e. it looks something like this on the number line. There's a key point there and a key point there. I don't colour in that one, but I colour in that one, and it's all the values like that. So the learning from this basically is, if you're given a double inequality, so you've got your 3x subtract 2 and it's bigger than something and it's less than or equal to something else, you can go away and solve this one independently, you can go away and solve this one independently, and in the end you can put your x in the middle with whatever answer you got this side with the right inequality and the number the other side with the right inequality. You can always do that. So let's have a go at some examples like that. Pause the video and see if you can do the following. Well, what I would do is I would go off separately and I would solve that one. And this is the only case where I don't move the x's. Because I know at the very end I'm going to have x in the middle, there's no point putting the x on the left-hand side here. Let's just solve it as we see it. Normally, when we see that all by itself, we'd probably put the x on the left-hand side. But here, just leave it for now. This is the case where it's better to leave it. Subtract 1 off both sides, and you'd get yourself that 2x there, and you would say 2x is bigger than 6, and then you would divide both sides by positive 2, and you would have yourself the x here bigger than 3. Right, that's that bit done. Now let's go off and do this inequality here with x's on both sides. So we have 2x add 1 is less than or equal to x add 15. To tidy that up, we would subtract x off both sides, and we would subtract 1 off both sides. And what would we get then? Well, on the left-hand side, we would get ourselves a single x. And on this side, we would get positive 14. And we would keep the less than or equal to sign. And to combine these at the end, we've got an x there and an x there. Write your x in the middle. And then keep that part of the sign there, less than or equal to 14. Keep that there, bigger than 3. And that is your solution. Right, let's try another one. Pause the video, have a go at that. Exactly the same thing applies. Why don't we just solve that one separately? So why don't we say, let's solve x subtract 10 is strictly less than, and while I'm at it, why don't I expand that out, 2x subtract 2. Okay, now let's try and solve this one. Again, leave your most x's on the right-hand side here. So we're going to try and get x's on the right-hand side and the numbers on the left-hand side. So let's subtract x from both sides. And let's add 2 to both sides. So what would we get? We'd get our x on the right-hand side. This is one of the only times we ever want the x on the right-hand side. Is strictly bigger than negative 10 add 2, which is negative 8. Okay? Now let's go off. And why don't we solve this one? So this is 2x subtract 2. If I expand that, 2x subtract 2 is strictly less than x. Now I want to solve this with x's on the left this time, so I'm going to subtract x off both sides, and to undo that add 2, let me add 2 to both sides. And tidying that up, what will I get? Well, I'll get myself that x here is strictly less than positive 2. Now combining the two together, I've got an x here and an x here, right, an x in the middle. Keep that part there, so x is strictly less than 2, and keep that part there, x is strictly bigger than negative 8. And that is the solution, and the best way to write the solution. Don't write your solution as two as separate ones. Write it as x is between positive 2 and negative 8, and we're done. Okay, let's have a go at another one. Pause the video and have a go if you can. Now hopefully you'll notice this one's slightly different to the previous one. In the previous one, x was in the middle, and we were solving two inequalities either side in the middle. This time here, we're solving two separate inequalities, one over here and one over here. And the question asks us to find the values of x which satisfy both inequalities simultaneously. That means at the same time. So what we're going to do is we're going to go off and we're going to solve this one and find the values of x. We're going to go off and solve this one and find the values of x. Then we're going to decide what values of x make them both be solved at the same time. So let's do that. Now because I'm not keeping x in the middle like previously where I was looking for x in the middle, I've got two separate inequalities. I'm going to go back to my old ways, and I like having the x on the left hand side. So if you don't mind, I'm going to rewrite this as 2 bracket x subtract 1 is bigger than 10. Now my only option is to expand the bracket, and I will get 2x subtract 2 is bigger than 10. I'm going to add 2 to both sides here, and I'm therefore going to get that 2x is bigger than 12, and I'm going to divide both sides by 2 to get the solution to the inequality on the left hand side, which is x is strictly bigger than 6, and we're done. Let's go and solve this one. I'm going to add 11 to both sides, and I'm going to get myself therefore that 3x is less than or equal to 33. Then to undo that, multiply by 3, divide both sides by 3, and I get myself that x is less than or equal to 11. Time to draw a number line. Quick sketch of a number line. Okay, why don't we mark that as 0. Mark the key points in 6 and let's say 11 here. Let's draw this inequality, x bigger than 6. Draw a circle at 6, don't color it in, and draw a line going the other side to the right hand side like that. Let's draw x less than or equal to 11. So this time let's have a circle at 11, but this time let's color the thing in because we want to include 11, but we want all the values less than or equal to 11 like that. Now we have to find out where they both happen at the same time. Where does that happen? Well, the top inequality, x less than or equal to 11, happens by itself along this part, and the inequality x bigger than 6 happens to itself all the way along that part. So where do they happen together? It's in between these two values here. So we have x in between 11 and 6, but we want to include 11 less than or equal to 11, but strictly bigger than 6. And that's our answer to this question. Let's try another one. Pause the video, have a go. Right, again, we're asked to find the values of x which satisfy both inequalities simultaneously. Let's solve this one separately. Let's solve this one separately. Let's draw a number line and let's see what values of x are they both true at the same time. So this one here, because they're independent from each other, I'm going to write the 3x subtract 2 is bigger than 10. I like writing it that way around. I'm going to add 2 to both sides, and I'm going to get myself therefore that 3x is strictly bigger than 12, and I'm going to divide both sides by 3, and I'm going to get myself the answer, the set of values x strictly bigger than 4. Let's solve this one. 3x subtract 5 is bigger than or equal to positive 1. Let's add 5 to both sides, and we'll get ourselves that 3x is therefore bigger than or equal to 6. Let's divide both sides by 3, and we're going to get ourselves x is bigger than or equal to positive 2. So let's draw a number line to see where they're both true at the same time. Quick number line here. Let's try and draw this one here. So let's 2 and 4 are going to be our key points. So why don't we draw 0 over here? Why don't we draw 2 here? And why don't we draw like 4 somewhere like here? X strictly bigger than 4. Draw a circle at 4 and draw an arrow to the right, but don't color in that circle. And for the other one, x bigger than or equal to 2, we're going to have our circle here, but we're going to color that one in, and we're going to have our line going to the right as well. Now the question is, when are they both true at the same time? Well, this one is true by itself here. But after that, they're actually both true at the same time from all values of x bigger than, strictly bigger than, that is, 4. You can see that they're both true at the same time all the way along here and all the way along here. So the answer, what values of x satisfy both inequalities at the same time, the answer in this case is x strictly bigger than 4. Anything, any x along here satisfies both at the same time, and that's it. So we're done for this particular skill. Thanks loads for watching.